Hey guys, Becky with Design Bundles here, and I'm super excited to have you join me today. We have another awesome Silhouette Studio tutorial. Today we are going to talk about your advanced color settings.
Okay guys, so here we are in Silhouette Studio, and I've already imported some clip art. Now, this clip art was a freebie I grabbed from Design Bundle, so it makes it really, really awesome in my opinion. I mean, it's awesome clip art anyway, but that I got it for free, that makes it doubly awesome, right? What I've done, I do have a design in mind, so I grabbed two different sets of book clip art, but then I also imported the main cover image. And that's going to be important in a minute, but I just wanted to explain what you're seeing on my screen here. Now, what I have this set for, actually in my mind, I'm thinking this is going to be a sublimation design. But guys, this tutorial is helpful for anybody that's printing or even designing anything digitally. Okay, so if you're printing, it's always really great to be able to have colors that match up perfectly. And then even for digital things, if you're trying to match anything on a website or other clip art or anything like that, it's also very useful. It's just not very useful if you're just cutting out vinyl or HTV or doing rhinestones or something like that, then of course you know that colors are not gonna make a difference for the ultimate outcome of your project, okay? But anything printable, sublimation, printable iron-on, digital saves, anything like that, that's where this advanced color option really comes in handy. So now that I have prefaced that, let's go ahead and get started. So let's talk about where your fill options or your color options are located. That's going to be over on the right-hand side here. You have a fill panel. Now remember, if you ever have a problem with the icons, you can come up here to the top toolbar and you have a panels menu that will give you the names that you can click on exactly to pull up that panel, okay? On the fill panel, you have a color chart that Silhouette Studio has provided for you. Now, you know, this is useful if you're just trying to get basic color options or maybe determine how something is going to look visually. It's just a very basic set of colors. So I always find, especially for certain shades that I'm trying to complement each other, this color chart can just feel a little lacking. So the first thing that we're going to talk about is how to select custom colors. Now, the easiest way is going to be the little eyedropper tool here. You can hover over any color in any of these designs. Let's see, let's get this teal blue color. And can you see how it changed the color of this icon once I clicked on it? And then it also added it to my recently used colors over here. So that's more of a temporary save. You can do that as many times as you want throughout, and you can grab several different colors, and it will just continue to add them to your recently used. And then once you're ready to add something with that color, you can just draw it on the mat. If it comes in transparent, which let's face it, usually it does, then of course you can come over here and just click on that color. Now phase two is gonna talk about using RGB and HEX color codes. If you click on your advanced color options down here, now, this is really useful when you don't have clip art that you're matching to. But there are some other reasons why you'd want to do that as well. For example, once I use my little dropper here and I snag a custom color from the clip art, you'll see I can come down here and I can get the RGB code and the HEX code for that exact color. Now, let's pause for a minute and let me tell you why that's useful. Because a lot of times when you're working with multiple platforms, for example, if I'm working in Silhouette Studio and maybe I'm also going to use this design on a website, or if I'm working in Silhouette Studio and for whatever reason I need to switch to my Cricut machine, being able to pull these custom colors is really important because then you know that you're using the same color across multiple platforms. I personally use it for my website designing anytime I need to set something up, or anytime that I'm working, say on a logo. If I have a logo that I'm trying to set up, then what I'll do is I will save those colors as a custom color palette so that I can have those in the future. But that way, whatever I'm designing that logo for, whenever I go back over to my website, I can match up those exact colors. So I know that probably doesn't seem very relevant unless that's something that you are doing regularly, but just know that this is how you gain access to HEX codes and RGB codes. Let me just show you a quick example. So I can copy, and I'm going to switch over to a Google search. What I can do is just type in hex code, and you will see that it will match up the color for the hex code that I input. Okay. Now, again, it may not seem super important, but sometimes it matters, especially if you're trying to match a hex code to an RGB code. Okay. Because, for example, Cricut Design Space, I noticed the other day that I can only input hex codes. So although Silhouette Studio will give that to me, just know that if you ever need to come out here and find more information about a hex code or color or get it transferred into an RGB, you can do that straight through Google. They're very common codes that are very well used among multiple platforms. As a matter of fact, here is a hex to RGB color converter. And as soon as I hit convert, it will give me those exact color codes and also give me a color preview. So in particular, if you are working with sublimation designs, then you will hear about RGB a lot in terms of trying to do color testing. For example, you will hear people say that you need to have 000 set for your RGB to get a true black. Okay. You'll also hear that about for your RGB color for red. You need 255 for red, 0 green, 0 blue to get a true red color. Now that doesn't mean that that's what it's going to turn out when you press it on your item, but this is more in terms of testing your inks. So if I need to create a purge file to test and make sure that all my color nozzles and heads are printing correctly, then what I'll do is I'll set up multiple blocks using these RGB color codes to make sure that, for example, I'm only printing red or I'm only printing yellow. And then I can examine and make sure that those color blocks are kind of where they need to be. But we are getting off track. We're getting off track. I'm just trying to give you some examples of when you would use these hex codes and these RGB codes, okay? Now let's talk about the reverse when we have an RGB code and we want to input it. So I'm back on Google and I'm just going to say RGB code for lime green. And of course I'll get several different options, and see, here's where I'm talking about the hex code and then also the RGB code. So if I wanted to do an RGB code, then I know that I need 50, 205 and 50. So I would just come down here and I would type in 50, 205 and 50. And that's going to give me a lime green. So then if I draw a shape, it'll fill with that lime green. And then the same rules would apply for hex codes. You would just type in the hex code that you need, and then you would be able to use that color in Silhouette Studio. All right, so I feel like I'm rambling a little bit. Let's get back on track. Let's talk about creating a new color palette. So I'm going to create a color palette. It's going to say back to school. I have a couple that are set up. These are just testers. So don't worry about creating a custom color palette and then it getting in the way. I can right click and I can delete any of these color palettes that I want to. Now, the name does not show until you hover over it. But when you hover over it, it'll show you the name. So like I said, if you were using this, if you had a certain, maybe a business logo or just maybe some favorite colors, or this is also really good if you work with skin tones because you can save these colors. So lots of really good options to save your custom color palettes. For now, what we're going to talk about is I'm going to grab my dropper and I'm going to come out here and I can grab any color that I want. Sometimes with watercolors, it may take you 2 or 3 tries just because sometimes that exact shade of wherever you're hovering over might be too pale for what you're looking for, or might even have too much color, just depending. So don't be surprised if watercolors are a little bit more difficult just to grab the exact color that you were looking for. But what I want to show you is you can just hit the plus and that color will be added to your color palette. I can do that for every color that I want to save from this group. Now, sometimes it doesn't like to pick up on the new colors. I'm not sure if that's just a bug in the software. So if you don't have that problem, then don't worry about this part. But I've noticed sometimes I have to come down here and just hit enter to kind of solidify this color. And then I can add it here to my color palette. Okay, so like I said, it's just a minor workaround. I'm not sure why that happens, but it kind of is what it is. Okay, so that's 5 colors. That's pretty good. So let's move on and I can get this out of the way. Now, like I said, let me back up. Like I said in the beginning, I like to bring this in, and that's mainly so that I can make sure if I'm setting up a custom color palette, I'll go ahead and grab all the colors included in that clip art. Because what that means to me is that these colors were selected by this artist because they are coordinating and corresponding colors. Usually my taste in colors, I think it's pretty good, but I do like to trust the artist because I myself am not an artist. I did not create these clip art. So I want to at least have all the colors handy if possible. Just that way in case I need them while I'm designing, I will have them. So let me go ahead and delete that. So I'm going to type out some text. Now I'm going to select this purple color. I like it a lot. And I'm going to change my line color to transparent because that line color can really affect how you see your design. And then I'm going to go through and select some fonts. Okay, so I know I tinker with that quite a bit. Thanks for sticking with me. But what you can do now is you can actually come in here to your custom color palette and you will be able to change these colors to anything you want them to be. Well, I think that I like the purple most of all. Purple just really speaks to me. I think it's a nice color. It's a nice shade of purple. So anyway, that is just a very simple example of being able to grab colors from that clip art to make sure that you're not selecting contrasting colors. And this works with clip art, this works with photographs, logos, anything. Like I said, you can even grab screenshots. For example, if I wanted to match a color, I know I keep talking about my website, but that seems to be the most common place where I need to grab these custom colors other than sublimation. So I can even take a screenshot of my website and bring that into Silhouette Studio to be able to color match that exact color to an accent piece that I'm trying to make for whether it's a button or an image. So I really love being able to do that. And there are just so many really great features using these advanced color options and things that you can do to really make your project or your clip art just really pop. I also like to use this a lot with patterns because patterns can be kind of tricky, being able to match up a color and having all these available to you kind of at your disposal so that you can switch back and forth between them easily really is a really easy designing hack. Now, of course, if this is a color palette that you want to save, you can leave it there. But once you're done with it, you can go ahead and delete it if you want. It's completely up to you. And just next time you're working with colors, remember that the advanced color features are there for you.
So guys, how do you feel about your advanced color settings in Silhouette Studio? Now, of course, I really use it a lot. Anybody who's using this for print and cut or sublimation or anything like that, that you just want to be able to color match to an exact color or set up your color charts. Don't forget about that video, especially if you are really working on your sublimation designing skills. But guys, hopefully I answered some of your questions today and hopefully you learned something from the video. Of course, if you have any questions or comments, please make sure you leave those below. I do absolutely love to hear from you guys. And if you learned something, if you don't mind, give us a quick like, share with a crafty friend, and subscribe to the channel. That helps us to keep the little channel going and to keep bringing you more videos in the future. So I'm gonna wrap it up for today, but guys, I do really appreciate it. I appreciate you taking time out of your day to stop by and pay me a visit. And thanks again. I will see you again next time.